and welcome to Families Online. I hope you guys are doing really well. Lucy, what are you thankful for today?
I'm really thankful for the sunshine and for having some lovely walks out in nature.
What
about you, Jess? What are you thankful for?
I am thankful that yesterday I made loads of Christmas decorations. Is it a bit early?
No, it's not too early.
It's never too early. Never too early for Christmas. Let us know in the chat if you think I'm a bit too keen. We would love to hear what you're thankful for and what you've been up to this week. So you've got a minute. Have a think. Pop it in the chat. Go. Well, fantastic. Thank you so much for sharing. It's great to hear what you guys are up to and what you're thankful for. I've got one thing to share with you that you need to be listening to. So, next week, we are not going to have Families Online because we are having a family celebration at 10:30. So instead of tuning in at 10 for Families Online, join at 10:30 for our main service. It'll be a family celebration. We've got a challenge planned. We've got worship. Got all sorts of fun stuff, so do come along to that.
That sounds brilliant. I'm really excited for that next week. But for now, we're going to hear from Karen in a bit about our spiritual discipline for this week, and then we're going to have another challenge for which you will need a pack of cards. So go grab those, and for now we're going to worship together.
Just one word, you calm the storm that surrounds me. Just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes are open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can do. Just one word, you hear what's broken inside. Just one word, and you revive every dream. Just one touch, I feel the power of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes are open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that our God can do. There's not a faith arise, let all agree, there's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe for greater things.
Today it is great to have you with us on Families Online. This morning I am filming from home, as you can see, and we are talking about prayer. Now I am sure most of you have heard the word prayer, or heard your parents talk about prayer, heard me talk about prayer, but what I want to know is what you think prayer is. So what I want you to do is either chat with someone in the room or pop it in the chat now. Great. Well, I'm hoping that some of you had some ideas about what prayer is. Maybe some of you said, well, you have to say, dear God, and you have to end with amen. Maybe some of you said you have to do thank you, sorry, please. Or you have to close your eyes and hold your hands like this and be quiet. I'm really hoping some of you, or at least one of you, thought it was talking and listening to God, or as I call it, chatting and catching with God. Now, don't get me wrong, all those things I've just named are ways of praying, okay? But I want to really want you to understand one thing. Jesus tells us to pray because he wants to be in a relationship with us. He wants to be friends with us. So, how do we get to know people? Well, we talk to them, don't we? We listen to them. We hang out with them, we have fun with them, we're silly with them. Sometimes we might get cross with them. We tell them little things, we tell them big things. It's how we get to know our friends and our family. We don't, for instance, we're sitting at the table and we go, dear mum, please, can you pass me the Cheerios? Amen. That would be be a bit odd, wouldn't it? No, we just go, please can you pass me the Cheerios? And we can talk to God just like that, because he wants to know everything about us and he wants to hear us tell him about everything and anything, however small or big. So you may not realise this, but a lot of us talk to God in our heads, quite a lot. So, for instance, I might be cycling to work and I'm probably daydreaming, to be honest. And then I might see a beautiful flower and I'd be like, oh, thank God. Thank you, Lord, for your creation. Or I might be driving, probably late, knowing me. I need a parking space. So I'll be like, Lord, please, can you find me a parking space? Or I don't know, I might be really tired and I've got to do something that I don't really want to do. So I'm like, help me, can you help me? Can you give me the strength? Can you give me the energy? Can you show me what I need to do? Have any of you ever done that? Have any of you chatted in your head like that with God? What I'd like you to do now is just pop in the chat when you think you could just chat to God about little stuff. Little bits of your everyday. So, just to recap, praying can be just talking about everything and anything. However small, however big, God is interested in every single part of our lives. And praying is just like talking to God. It's just an adult word, a strange word. It is a word that Jesus uses, but all it means is telling God stuff. Talking to God, listening to God, being in a relationship with God. So, we are going to do a little bit of that right now. We are going to spend some time telling God stuff. And I suggest you find somewhere comfortable and you close your eyes to help you concentrate. However, because we don't have to sit down and we don't have to close our eyes and it doesn't have to be long words or big sentences, if you want to do this while doing a headstand or dancing around the room, you go for it, okay? I'm going to make some suggestions of what we tell God. If you want to tell him other stuff, tell him other stuff. And just suggestions to help you connect with God and chat to him. Okay, so I'll just give you a second to get a little bit ready. So, what I'd like you to tell God is about something really funny that's happened recently. And I'd like you to tell him the whole story about it. Go into as much detail as you would like. If you've finished doing that, tell God something that has made you sad or worried or anxious. And tell him what it is, why it's made you feel that way, and maybe ask him to help you. And lastly, but you can carry on for as long as you want, tell God about something you're really looking forward to. Tell him why you're looking forward to it, what it is, when it's going to happen, if you know. Just tell him all about it. That's great. Well, if you want to carry on chatting to God, you can do it whenever you want. There is more stuff on the website in Families, SDBS/families. The link will come up at the end of Families Online. There's the Bible story. There'll be a craft for younger kids. There's probably some sort of activity. And it shows you what Jesus says about prayer in that. So do get someone to download that for you to have a look at. And I want you to give it a go this week. Think about some times when you could just chat to God. Maybe coming home from school, tell him about your day. Tell him some of the really little things and the big things. Just tell him anything, okay? And I think I'm going to hand back to Jess and Lucy, who are doing the challenge.
Well, thank you so much, Karen, for sharing that. Lucy, what is our challenge today?
So our challenge for this week, we need to sort out our cards and take all of our kings, queens, jacks, tens and aces out of our pack. So we should have 20 cards altogether in our pile. We then need to lay them out on our table in front of us in like a grid. making sure that they're really well shuffled.
Okay. Oh, that's a lot of cards.
It is.
Okay, so we've got our aces, kings, queens, jacks and tens.
Mm-hmm.
Randomly on the table in a grid upside down, so they're all face down. Okay, what do we do now?
So now we can only use one hand to turn over cards, and we have to match them into their five different sets.
So all
as fast as we can.
Hearts, clubs, spades and diamonds.
Yes.
Okay. Whew. It's gonna be quick. It's gonna be tricky. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready? So just one hand. I'll
and it's a race to see who can do it quickest.
Yeah.
Okay. If you're ready at home, give it a go. If not, give it a go in a minute once we're finished. And we'd love to hear how quickly you do it and if you managed to do it before us. Are you ready?
Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go!
Go! Do they have to be in order as well?
Oh, that I think, well, don't think so. That's okay. That's an extra challenge. If you find this really easy, that's your next challenge, is to put them all in order.
This is so tricky. It's actually harder than it looks. I was expecting it to be easy. Club and tots.
Oh, well done. Yes. That was good.
That was close as well.
It was very close this week. Well, let us know how you get on with that. Mm. And yeah, if you want an extra challenge, see if you can put your cards in order as well.
That'd be tricky. Right, so we're going to finish there. Remember that next week we won't have families online, so join at 10:30 on the main service for our family celebration. Until then, have a great week. We've got resources as well. Where can you find the resources?
At stbs.org.uk/families online, you'll find all the resources for today's session there.
So have a look at that, and we'll head over to the main service now. So see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.